I was one of the kids that would see R. Kelly up at Kenwood. I mean, it's not like, or at the McDonald's, we would see him. I mean, he would be there. And I, so that's not allegedly. I saw with my own eyes.
Right.
This is, I think seeing the reaction from people, like Val was saying, has been the most surprising to me.
Mm-hmm.
Because many people, in many ways, people just brush off young Black women and say, oh, these little fast little girls. Mm-hmm. And we've been hypersexualized in this society. This is, I know I'm using the comedian on here, but I'm about to get real for a minute. When we look at the backlash of just our history in this country, slavery and things of that, the aftermath of being bred to breed at 9 years old, it's very understanding now why when you're a girl between the ages of 9 and 13, we're sexualized. People don't see us as victims. You know, we were sold on auction blocks to have babies and to create mm-hmm. babies. So it makes perfect sense now that you just dismiss a 13-year-old Black girl or a 14-year-old Black girl and say, oh, well, she's just fast. And it's like, as the adult, you should know you should not be having sex with a 13 or 14 or 15-year-old.
Right, right.
It is what it is.
Right.
And the thing is, when you know, the sex trafficking and things that are going on, and every day in Auburn Gresham where I live, there's a new poster up of a young girl that has been abducted for sex trafficking. This is real. This is really happening. And I think that, yeah, put the spotlight on R. Kelly, but there are bus drivers, there are teachers at schools, there are pastors that are doing these kind of things. So I'm hoping that this will open people's eyes to really pay attention to what's going on.
Right. Now, having that been said, the reports are now that his music and the streaming has actually gone up, and people are downloading his music just like it was 1990 right now.
Well, I think some people are curious to, now they want to play detective and listen to some of these lyrics. Age ain't nothing but a number.
Right.
Like you're ready. And
yeah.
I mean, and people have fully on been in denial that the accusations could even be true.
Right.
But, you know, I remember when the rumor was that R. Kelly had married Aaliyah. On the documentary, it's supposedly that she had gotten pregnant by him.
Exactly. At 15,
at
before
15.
The marriage license that he was
yes.
Yeah. But I remember back in the day, people just like, oh, well, that couldn't be true. He could get so many women our age. Why would he want to have sex with a young girl? But there are lots of men that like to have sex with young girls. Mm-hmm. That's why girls between the ages of 9 and 13 are coming up missing in Chicago for sex trafficking. They're part of it's a real thing.
Yeah. And it's a real thing, too, that now in the documentary, we are learning that he allegedly was molested at a young age mm-hmm. of 8 years old. And that is maybe some of the folks' reasons for
right.
why he is the way he is. But even if that is the case, he needs help.
Well, if he was molested as a child, and
there's
knows
no
the harm and the hurt he felt when it happened to him, why would that be used as an excuse of why he would repeat the behavior?
But that is exactly the excuse. Because
well,
it happened to me, it's generational, and it
yeah.
just goes
oh,
on.
No,
it
I
is no excuse.
But
I get what you're saying.
But to say it as in, let's give him a pass. Well, we know somebody molested him, so let's give him a pass.
Right.
But
yeah.
I have friends that have
yeah.
been sexually assaulted as children, and they don't also
right.
sexually assault children.
Remember, these are all allegations
as
right
allegations.
Now. He was acquitted in 2008, remember, of the videotape that came out in 2000.